Hello, Tom Frezza here from the Naval History and Heritage Command with another Artifact Spotlight. This is where we take a look at the Navy's timeline and pull out different artifacts from that timeline and teach you about them. And today we're going to be focusing on two items from the Naval Amphibious Force from World War II. Now, the two items that we have here actually belong to the same sailor, a sailor from Providence, Rhode Island by the name of Manuel B. Leal, Jr., and the two items are a certificate and a patch. Now, the certificate shows that Leal actually graduated from the Fort Pierce Naval Amphibious Training Base in Florida. The Fort Pierce Naval Amphibious Training Base was constructed in 1943 and fulfilled two primary missions during World War II. Its original mission was that as an amphibious training base, including training for naval underwater demolition teams, the precursor to the Navy SEALs. Sailors were trained in operating all types of landing craft on several simulated beaches. There was even a mock hull that was used to train sailors how to load and unload landing craft with the use of landing nets. Now, during 1943, with the lead-up to several different invasions and landings in the Pacific and the Atlantic, a joint Army-Navy experimental and testing board was established to develop and test procedures for breaching and removing beach fortifications expected to be encountered in Europe and Japan. Beaches were fortified along the northern portion of the base, and a variety of ordnance was tested against these fortifications. Now, Fort Pierce is not a naval amphibious training center anymore down in Florida. By 1946, the site was no longer needed, and the land was returned to the original owners. Now, after graduating from the U.S. Naval Training Center in Sampson, New York, in November of 1944, Manuel Leal was sent to Fort Pierce to learn the duties of a Navy coxswain. The certificate here actually states that Leal, who graduated Fort Pierce, would be authorized to wear the Naval Amphibious Forces shoulder patch, the one that you see here. And that leads me to the second artifact that you see here, which is the World War II era Naval Amphibious Forces shoulder patch, which was owned by Manuel B. Leal, Jr. The patch has a domed top and a flat base. It's embroidered red, and it has a gold depiction of an eagle, an anchor, and a Thompson submachine gun. These figures signify the close collaboration of air, sea, and ground units in amphibious warfare. Now, the Naval Amphibious Forces shoulder patch was actually the first device of its kind authorized by the Navy. Similar in design and function to the shoulder insignia that was worn by the Army and the Marine Corps, it identified the sailor as a member of the Naval Amphibious Forces. It was worn on the left shoulder above the rating badge. And the Naval Amphibious Forces were responsible for transporting soldiers and Marines ashore, often under heavy enemy fire. They are instrumental in the Pacific theater of World War II, enabling U.S. forces to land at Iwo Jima, Okinawa, among many other places. The Naval Amphibious Forces insignia was authorized in June of 1944 to be worn by enlisted personnel who either completed training in amphibious warfare at bases of the Amphibious Training Command, were on duty with scouts or raiders, naval combat demolition units, beach jumpers, joint assault signal companies, beach battalions, or standard landing craft units, or were serving aboard the vessels that were carrying out the primary landings. Now, by the end of 1944, this patch was not the only patch that was authorized by the Navy. You see, three more patches were actually authorized for sailors to wear. These included the motor torpedo boat personnel, minecraft personnel, and the naval construction battalion personnel, the Seabees. Now, however, By January 1947, the Navy revoked the authorization to wear shoulder patches from then on. So that's why you see, again, these shoulder patches kind of going away after World War II. And Manuel B. Leal Jr. did wear this shoulder patch and carried this card throughout his time in the Pacific and during occupation duty in China after World War II. And the reason why we know so much about him and we have these items here and so many images of him is because there's a personal connection. Manuel B. Leal Jr. is my grandfather. And with that, if you would like more information on the Naval Amphibious Forces during World War II, please visit the website of the Naval History and Heritage Command, history.navy.mil, and we'll see you at our next Artifact Spotlight.